The reenactment you're going to see is the reality of what the emergency personnel deal with on a daily basis across America. Statistics have shown that on the average, there's a fatal accident involving alcohol every 15 minutes. If you add the other distractions, such as texting and driving, the frequency of fatality accidents increases even more. Our hope this morning is that you will pay close attention to what you see and what you're about to witness and accept the challenge to make smart decisions so that you don't become one of the statistics. This is not fun. It's a serious thing, so we want you to pay attention. Thank you for being here.
Not yet. They're getting ready to run. Yep, there they go.
Attention, Beebe Fire Department, Rescue 1 with Engine 1. Respond to the 100 block of Opportunity Drive for a motor vehicle accident with injuries and possible entrapment. Cross Street is West Center. Timeout is 10:30. Dispatch, 2752.
Go ahead, dispatch.
Respond with Rescue 1 and Engine 1. The 100 block of Opportunity Drive for a motor vehicle accident with injuries.
Copy, Opportunity Drive,
Shelton Route. Maybe all units respond with Fire Department and NorthStar 100 block of Opportunity Drive for motor vehicle accident with injuries.
Thank you. I see the 6401. I see the 6604. Please wait. Currently need a med flight.
10-4 dispatch, going contact survival, get them in the air.
602.
Go ahead. Do you have an ETA on survival flight? I'll check it now. Copy.
Thing to do. Texas 1072. 10-4, as soon as the motor takes off, he's ready to leave.
Sentencing you to 10 years in Arkansas Department of Corrections, $10,000 fine. I am revoking your driver's license. When you finish your term in Arkansas Department of Corrections and you want to get out and you want to drive again, you will have to reapply for a driver's license. You will have to take the written test again. You will have to take the driving test again. You are going to have trouble finding a job, as I said, because of your choices. Mr. Granfield, they say that a foolish man never learns. A smart man learns from his mistakes. A wise man learns from the mistakes of others. It appears that you've been foolish to now. And where you go from here depends a lot on your own actions and your own thoughts. You're going to have time to think about everything that has transpired. And I hope when you get out that you will be a different man. You will have a different life, a better life. I suspect that if you haven't found God now, you will find him while you are in ADC. And he can give you strength. never saw. It was probably about 12 or 13. And it was at an intersection just south of Hazen. There's a, if you go down Highway 11 headed towards Stuttgart, there is a utility electrical transformer station there on the east side of the highway. And we were going on a trip, my mom, dad, my sister, and myself. And a drunk driver came from a side highway, from a side dirt road right there beside that transfer station in a pickup. And he pulled out in the highway in front of a brown Pontiac. Trouble because we never got the coat back. But that kind of stuff will leave a lasting impression on you. I remember asking when the police officers got there, I asked them, I said, what about the man in the truck? Because no one seemed to be concerned about him. And they said, don't worry about him, he's dead. And it's one of the reasons that I am tougher on DWIs, I think, than a lot of the judges. I've seen people, I know people who have loved ones that have been killed. I have friends who had brothers and sisters that have had exactly this happen, where they get drunk, they run a stop sign, something, they kill someone, they end up going to the Arkansas Department of Corrections. And I'm absolutely correct when I tell you that if something like this happens to you, whether you are the driver, whether you are a passenger with a drunk driver, or whether you are a victim in the other vehicle, it will live with you. I have a friend that was driving down around Hickory Flat years ago at night. A guy under the influence, drunk, was walking down the wrong side of the highway, in the highway, wearing dark clothes. My friend never saw him until he just right there, he hit him. The guy went over his pickup, hit the trailer in the back, of course, he killed him. And that's probably been about 10 or 12 years ago. And Jim says there's not a day goes by that he doesn't remember that. Even though he wasn't at fault, killed somebody. And that's something hard to live with. But I'm also absolutely serious when I say that a smart man learns from his mistakes and a wise man learns from the mistakes of others. And the Beebe Fire Department, Beebe Police Officers, Emergency, NorthStar Emergency Medical Services, Arkansas State Police, they all present this to you hoping that it will leave an impression, even though no one died out there. They are hoping that all of you will be wise people, that you will learn from this, that even though seen the horror of what can and will in most likelihood happen. So that you never drink and drive, you will never be in this position. You will never stand in court for one of those. And you will never have to resume the rest of your life knowing that this is what you did and this is what happened because you won't forget it. Now, court's adjourned.
Sweet. We can't say it any better than Judge Derrick just said. My name is Trooper Drew Handel, Arkansas State Police. This is my partner, Corporal Tony Bowman. I recognize some of your faces. Some of y'all probably recognize me from the south of around here. I'm a local trooper around here. This is my hometown. This is where I'm at. So I'm just going to keep it sweet, short and sweet and to the point today. Thing is, from what you saw out here, guys, this is no joke, okay? We've all been young. We've all been stupid. We've all made bad choices, but at the same time, guys, this is no joke. We don't have any desire to sit out here and be wanting to. I don't want to get that call anytime this weekend, or anytime as far as that goes. We don't want to get that call that we have to come out here and end up working one of these wrecks on you. Okay, it's not just that it leaves an impact on you. If you happen to survive, that it leaves an impact on you. It leaves an impact on us. Okay, I got a kid here in the Beebe Public Schools coming up in junior high. And the thing is, and I recognize friends, I recognize faces. We don't want to work this stuff. But the biggest thing is, too, guys, this is going to last with you for a lifetime. As Judge Derrick stated, this don't go away tomorrow. This isn't something that you can wake up tomorrow and pretend like it's a bad dream. Even if you happen to survive these accidents and you go on with life, the thing is, the effect on the fact that you get a DWI out here, you're not going to have insurance anymore. Okay. You probably don't think about that right now because your parents may be paying your insurance, but your parents are going to affect it, I promise. They'll feel it. They're going to kick you off insurance. If you don't have insurance, you can't legally drive down this road, not to count that you're going to lose your driving privileges. Everybody here, probably when you got to the age of 16, your big thing was you wanted to drive, right? We all did. I'm telling you, you catch a DWI, you're out. You won't be driving for a while. And if you do, as the judge put it, you're going to be having a hard go to go back to it. You remember how hard it was to get them? Go back to them later after you've been driving for a while and hadn't looked at that book. But the other part is nobody around here wants to kill a friend, okay? I had two friends killed in high school myself by drunk drivers. One of them was drunk himself and hit another car, and the other car actually was drunk also. But I had another friend that he was completely sober, riding with a friend who'd been drinking, that they got in a fight at a party because he refused to let him drive even though he was sober. They made it a mile and a half down the road. He crashes. The guy that was drunk walked away. Our friend that was completely sober died, okay? It's no joke, guys. The legal effects, like I said, you catch you a prison sentence, it's going to be hard to get out here and make a living. College goes away. How many here would rather sit in a jail cell and go to college and have a good time in life, you know? The thing is, it's for real. It's something to think about. You know, and the other thing to think about this weekend, I'm just going to put in before we get out of here, is that, you know, just because you're not drinking and driving behind the wheel, if you're doing them drugs and you're behind the wheel, you're impaired as you are you're as impaired as you are with alcohol, okay? It carries the same penalties. If we catch you doing drugs and behind the wheel of that car, that counts marijuana, pills, meth, anything you're on. If we determine that you're impaired and you're not out here driving in a safe manner, you can catch a DWI just like the next guy, okay? It's for real. I know everybody here is hung up on thinking marijuana is okay because they're trying to make it legal and all this stuff. I'm going to tell you right now, it's not legal. And we're going to prosecute you to the fullest with it if we catch you with it, especially driving behind the wheel of that car, okay? Just like with the DWI, I can promise you, myself, my partner Tony here, any of these other state troopers back here, we pull you over this weekend and we find out you've been drinking, I'll make you a promise right now, and you can take it with you, that we will prosecute you to the fullest, okay? It's for real. You saw the parent thing. That's always a big impact for me, even all these we do. If there's one thing, I love this job. This is a job I've always wanted to do in life. But I'm going to tell you, the death notifications, that is the worst part of this job that I hate even having to do it, okay? There ain't nothing worse than us having to show up here in the middle of the night, knocking on one of your parents' door to let them know that you've been out here and been involved in an accident and you're not coming home, okay? You saw a little bit up there and some acting, but I'm telling you, it's for real, all right? So this weekend, when you think about it again, if you need anything, like I said, I'm here in this town. This is my hometown. I want to help everybody I can, and I sure don't want to see you in these situations. So if you need anything, you come to me. I'll help you any way I can. But don't let me catch you on the other side out here drinking and driving or doing drugs behind the wheel of that car, okay?
Pretty much hit on everything. The next of kin notifications are the worst part of my job that I ever have to do. You have to contact parents, mothers and fathers, whoever, and tell them I had to come to Beebe one time here in town and had to do a next of kin notification. The father had got killed by a drunk driver and a little robber. I went and knocked on the door of this young man's house. He was playing video games. He didn't have a clue why I was there. I had to find his mom and tell her, and then we went and told him together. But it's the most horrifying part of the job that we do. That is out there. It was a good representation of what happens on the highway, but in by no means is that it's not close as far as the smell of blood, the smell of death, the smell of alcohol mixed in with all that. It is, it's quite a bad experience to have to deal with. Sometimes we have to deal with our friends, people that we know. I've had to deal with that several times. There's screaming, there's hollering, and there's pain. There's not a heck of a lot you can do about it at the time. Understand this one thing, if we stop you out there for DWI, driving while intoxicated, drugs or alcohol, I will not feel sorry for you at all, ever. I will prosecute you. We all will. It's not what I want to do. It's what we have to do. And so do yourself a big favor. Pay attention while you're driving. Wear your seatbelts. And It's called practicing integrity. Integrity is doing the right thing because nobody's looking. Because as you graduate and you get out on your own, you're going to be doing a lot of things that you probably are now, doing a lot of things that your parents, you know, they're not right there with you all the time. Practice integrity. That's doing the right thing even when nobody's looking. You'll feel better for it, and you'll probably be a lot safer. Anyway, I hope y'all enjoyed this today. It was a learning experience for you. Beebe Police Department put this on. Great job to Beebe PD. The reason they got all this together is because they care. A cop may come off as some kind of cold guy, and I'm sure y'all think that about me now, but we really do care. We care about y'all.
Real quick, guys, let's go ahead and give them another round of applause. They have done a